We're going to remove a little bit of this vein here. You can see you have magnetite, some sulfides, some hematite, and quartz here. Loads of sulfides in a mineralized quartz vein, pyrite, chalcopyrite, magnetite, a little bit of AU in there too. So what we want to do is take a sludge to some of it. We're also going to take the DeWalt to this to make it a little bit easier. We want to get some fresh unweathered samples. Lots of weathering on this, so break away at it and get some nice fresh pieces. Sulfides in there. Different layers we're going into. Just try to make some weak points to make it a little bit easier to break off. New battery. Nice black stuff coming out of there. Possibly some magnetite. So what we've actually decided to do is, we know there's AU in this because we've had this being tested, but we want to see if there's remil, or if it's in your sulfides, or if it's both. So we're just gonna take some of this drilled out material that's already fine, and we'll pan that out a bit later. There we go. Definitely see the foliations in the schist. You can see schist, solid sulfide vein there. That's a pretty nice looking sample. Magnetite throughout that. Okay, who didn't charge the batteries? Just like a solid sulfide vein. Material here. There we go. Exactly what we wanted. That is a nice sample. This weighs about 5 pounds. Magnetite, pyrite. You have chalcopyrite in here too. Lots of oxidized pyrite for sure. So there's your host rock schists, disseminations of pyrite and chalcopyrite attached to your quartz. Scrape a little of this material down here for a pan. A couple more samples here, little drill holes. Definitely got magnetite in there. Lots of magnetite in this one, quartz, disseminated sulfides, and masses of sulfides. Another nice sample there. Basically a solid mass of mineral. So, why don't we pull a couple more samples from down below here, and then we'll pan out that material right here and see what we can pull out of that, if there's any gold. Perfect. Not bad for a left-handed swing, or I guess that's right-handed. Alright, another decent sample here. We got more here. So we got our pan here. We're down by nearby creek. You can just see it's loaded with sulfides, and I think I actually see a piece of fine gold right there. So let's pan it out. We got pretty decent assay results when we test this, so we should see some gold in the pan, maybe a few specks, maybe more, hopefully. Probably should have classified this out because there's some bigger rocks in there. Pan's extremely heavy. That's pretty much all sulfides there. It's going to be a little bit difficult to pan down. Now we're just down to the really fine iron sulfides there. Clean it up a bit. Ah, we got some gold in there. Looks like pretty big pieces too. Okay. Look at that. There's some big chunks in there. I would expect to be quite a bit finer. I guess there is quite a bit of fine gold in there, but like, look at this piece right here. Wire gold. So that's the best I'm gonna be able to do right now. We got maybe 100 pieces of fine gold in there, some bigger pieces, some more down here. A lot of it's wire gold, it's looking like. You can see this piece right here, look at that. That's the biggest one, but that is pretty cool looking. It's like crystalline wire gold. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed the video. We're losing daylight, so we gotta get out of here. We'll see you guys in the next one.